Now let's meet an authority on our friends the plants.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Christopher Bird.
Number two.
My name is Christopher Bird.
Number three.
My name is Christopher Bird.
A marvelous name for such a gentleman. Of course, only one of them truly is Christopher Bird, and here's the story. It says, I, Christopher Bird, am a biologist and anthropologist. Together with Peter Tompkins, I have written a book that explores the latest scientific knowledge about plants and their ability to communicate. Titled The Secret Life of Plants, we discuss experiments that show that plants appear to have emotions and that they communicate with each other by the wavelengths of their fragrance and the color of their petals. There also seems to be some sort of interaction between plants and humans. In fact, there have been reports of men starting model trains by attaching a plant to the electrical mechanism. Evidence strongly suggests that plants respond to music more readily to classical than to rock. In conclusion, I maintain that the most far-reaching revolution in the 20th century, one that may save or destroy the planet, may come from the bottom of your garden. Signed, Christopher Bird. And we'll start the questioning with the temporarily transplanted Mr. Gene Wood.
Thank you, Gary. I, incidentally, am very much interested in this particular field because I do believe that I have a plant of my own that I talk to. We don't communicate too much because it's rather surly. You know, I say, good morning, plant, and it says, don't bug me. You know, that kind of thing. Number two, what kind of energy do plants transmit, do you know?
Well, they react to sonic energy and electromagnetic energy. But the real baffling communication to and from plants is an energy that we don't really understand.
Number three, how do you interpret this energy? What do you use? What electrical device do you use to measure it?
Well, what you do is you electrode the plant, and then it's attached to a machine, like something like a lie detector. Mm-hmm. And when the plant gets a reaction, it kind of pours electrical energy into that, and a signal comes out written on paper, moving paper with a pen.
Thank you, number three. Number one, are plants, have you ever heard of a case where plants have been used in solving a criminal case?
Yes, the Russians, who are very big in this, did record one event where a plant was able to detect the criminal among a lineup of suspects.
Betsy,
oh,
you can't
I'd
trust
like...
anybody anymore.
No,
you don't dare talk in front of your petunia. Terrible. Bill Cullen.
Oh, no, what about me?
Kitty Carlisle. I was thinking of you as a flower, my dear.
That brings me to my next question. If I'm such a nice flower, aren't they sensitive, those plants, number one? And don't they cry when you cut them?
They don't exactly cry, but they do give out reactions which can be measured electrically and with a graph on paper.
Thank you. And would you finish your story that you started for Mr. Wood about the criminal? Did the plant have a special reaction when confronted with the real one?
Yes, because the crime, it was a murder actually, had been carried out in the presence of the plant.
Right.
Plants are very sensitive to the destruction of any life, animal or vegetable.
Uh-huh. Thank you. Thank you very much. Number three, how do they communicate with each other by the color?
Well, it's not really known how they do, but I think...
Well, how do you know they do then?
Because there seem to have been some experiments in gardens where if you put certain plants in conjunction with other plants, they grow much faster and better than if they're planted, let's say, with certain other plants.
I see. Thank you. Number two, is it true that a cornfield...
Oh, what a good question, and whatever it is. Is it true that a cornfield... You'll go to sleep tonight worrying about it. A cornfield. I know I would. However, it's time to go to Bill Cullen.
Number one, the plant in Russia testified because the murder had been committed in front of the plant in Russia. Is that what you said?
It didn't exactly testify in the normal way, but the scientists were able to demonstrate that plants did react, And this plant did react in the presence of this criminal. Together with other factors involved, this was conclusive in that particular case.
I know four plants in the bedroom that are going to lose a home when I get there. I told you tonight. Those plants go out and burn themselves.
Give me a
we just got a buzzer, Bill. We're going to lift you up and go to pay a cat.
I know the canaries told everybody. Oh, excuse me.
number one, I have absolutely loads of plants in my dining room, and they flourish. They really do very well, and I never talk to them. Nobody ever talks to them. They're always alone because I never eat in my dining room. I eat in the kitchen. So would you please explain that to me?
It's not that people with black thumbs are actually killers of plants.
Oh, my God, they're flourishing. What do you mean,
yes,
black thumbs?
Yes, well, people with green thumbs can make plants flourish better. I mean, in fact, it has been a constant factor that's been shown in experiments that people can be divided into two groups. The so-called black thumbs, who just take regular care of plants, and the green thumbs, who can take super care of plants. This is very interesting from the point of view of human psychology.
Yes.
In fact, Georg von Krantz of Nuremberg.
Who is that?
Georg von Krantz.
I see.
I beg your pardon, it's Tübingen. He demonstrated that the green thumb people had a very strong...
That's the guy. It's
got to
be.
Had a very, very strong field of negative ions around it.
Well, I myself am well known for the blight touch.
I trust that you're at least satisfied with the answers that you got. And on the basis of what we've learned from everybody, I hope you'll mark your ballots. And you'll mark your ballots accordingly to for number one, or number two, or number three. And Gene Wood is going to get the first opinion voiced here. And
right, Gary. And I have chosen number one with leaves. And the reason I have chosen him is because number three did not use the word sensor, which is what they attach to the plants in order to get the electrical vibration. Number one really seemed to know where it's at, so I went with him.
Very well. We got a one showing. I'm kidding.
Well, number one was absolutely marvelous. Nevertheless, I voted for number three.
Anytime Kitty says somebody number what was simply marvelous, I know the next word is going to be but or nevertheless or however. We have a three. We have a one. Bill Cullen.
Number one did a marvelous, excellent, excellent job, but I think he couldn't be the real winner. He wouldn't have told us all that. And anyway, number three has a beard that is flourishing, and I say that man has a green razor there. I voted for number three.
Got a green chin. All right, we got a pair of threes and one. And Peggy, where are you going to go?
Well, I thought you're all darling, but number one, I had to vote for you because, by God, you earned it.
All right, they're posed on both ends. A couple of pairs of votes are in. Well, the real Christopher Bird, sir, please stand up.
Come on, Chrissy Bird.
There! Oh, great. Mr. Bird, a lot of good information. Let's find out who your friends are. Number one, with a magnificent imagination, what is your real name and where are you from? What do you do?
My name is Anthony Lloyd. I teach English in Brooklyn.
You're kidding. Number two, sir, you have a kindly face. Plants should like you, I think. What is your real name? What do you do?
I'm Bob Sawyer. I'm a clergyman, pastor of a Moravian church here in Midtown Manhattan.
Well, you couldn't lie. Yes, go on. Well, thank you, Christopher Bird. It's a fascinating subject. And thank you, gentlemen, also for being with us on To Tell the Truth. Take care now. We've all heard an awful lot about this business of playing music for your plants and talking to your plants taking your plants for a walk or whatever. Do any of you have any belief in that theory?
Yes, because cornfields I was going to tell you, cornfields that have music at night as opposed to cornfields that don't flourish better.
They grow bigger.
Well, they grow bigger.
But tougher.
Yes.
But tougher?
Maybe it's, I don't know. I think it's a lot of nonsense if you really want to know.
I don't think so.
If you have a nice damp atmosphere and a lot of sun, your plants will do well and it's a lot of hoop.
Yeah, but it's like...
I had a plant one time. I talked to the thing very gently, very lovingly, and for about 3 years, a period of 3 years, and it grew about a half an inch.
Mm.
Which isn't a great deal, but when you consider it was an artificial plant.
Very good.
We'll see you around.
Characters today will receive the Papermate Executive Pen and Pencil Set, featuring the Papermate PowerPoint Pen, the pumps ink to the point so it writes at any angle. Papermate. Promotional consideration provided by Les Weston Motels, the nation's largest chain of 1,255 owner-operated motels in 900 cities throughout the United States, Canada, and Mexico. This is Bill Wendell speaking for you to tell the truth. A Mark Hudson, Bill Cotman production.